friends, today we are going to discuss about the very interesting topic, that is the evaluation matrix of the classification models. So here entire evaluation matrix concept I was divided into three parts: part 1, part 2, part 3. So part 1 I have to discuss about the sum of the matrix, and part 2 I have to discuss about the sum of the matrix, like that. So total evaluation matrix are total 8. So what are those? So accuracy, misclassification rate, which is also known as error rate, precision, recall is also known as sensitivity, F1 score, specificity. So ROC curve means receiver operator characteristic, and AUC, area under curve. So those are the 8 parameters, 8 evaluation metrics that existed. So in part 1 we have to discuss about the up to 5 metrics: accuracy, misclassification rate, precision, recall, F1 score. So before going to discuss about the evaluation means accuracy, precision, call, first we have to discuss about the confusion matrix. So what is the confusion matrix, and what is the confusion matrix for the binary class classification? So what is the binary class classification means? So if the target variable has the only two classes, that is the 0 or 1, or positive or negative, or male or female, yes or no, like this. Only the target variable have the only two classes. Two classes means either 0 or 1, positive or negative, like that. If it is more than two classes, that is the multi-class classification. So in this part 1, we are going to discuss about the only binary class. So in next lectures, I have to discuss about the multi-class. So what is the confusion matrix? So confusion matrix is a tabular representation to describe the performance of the classification model or the classifier on the test data set. So what is the test data set? So already in my previous lectures, I already discussed the test data set. Even now I will also again explain the test data set. And it allows the visualization of the performance of the algorithm. And next one, it is the confusion matrix is the n by n matrix. It is used for the evaluating the performance of the classification model. So what is the n? So n is nothing but the number of target classes. Suppose the binary classes, that is the 2x2 matrix. So n means there are the only two classes, that is the either 0 or 1. If it is 3x3 matrix means 0, 1, 2, like that. So the matrix compares the actual target values with this predicted by the machine learning models. So means that we have to compare the actual target values with the predicted values by the model. So if you see in this example, actually the data set shape is 1000, 8000 rows and 8 columns. So the data set is divided into two parts, means like that X and Y. So X and Y means, so this is the input variables, Y is the target variable. So here the entire data set of 1000 rows of 8 columns, we are divided into training data and the test data. So suppose I am considering 90% of the data we have to use for the train the model, and just 10% of the data we have to use the test the model. So in the training data, X and Y both are existed. So in the test data also, X and Y are existed. So in the in this 90% of data means like that. This is the 90% of the data. So here how many features are existed? So this is the feature 1, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6 and x7. So there are the 7 input features. This is the target feature. So this target feature has the only two values, that is 1s and 0s, only two classes. That is the binary class. So what is this problem? So this is the data set about the whether the person is suffering from the disease, like nowadays people are suffering from the corona. So how can you classify the person is suffering from the corona or not? So based on this, some input features means based on some parameters. So suppose based on here there is 7 parameters x1 to x7. So based on age, fever, difficulty in breath and dry cough, loss of smell, headache, chest pain. So age means number, so this is the input data. Fever, so difficulty in breath 1 or 0. So 1 means he is suffering from the breathing, 0 means not suffering, like that. So this is the dummy data set, not the exact data set. So for example purpose I am taking this data set. So based on these 7 features, we have to classify the whether the person is infection to the person from the corona or not, yes or no. So this is the training data. So training data means this is the 90% of data we have to use to the you can give to the machine learning algorithm. Suppose you am taking the logistic regression. So logistic regression algorithm applied on the training data set. Now we have to build the model, that is the classification model. So next, what we have to do, we have to take the 10% of the test data set. So in the 10% data set, only input features. See, if you see, this is the x1, x2, x3, 4, 5, 6, 7, only input feature, there is no target variable. So only the test data set, we have to give this data to the model. The model will predict the labels, means predict the labels, means this is the H1 labels and model predicted the 1, 0, like that, based on the performance of the model. So if you see, this is the confusion matrix. So in this confusion matrix, this is actually binary class. So binary class be divided into 2 by 2, 2 rows 2 columns, 2 rows 2 columns. So on the y-axis, this is y-axis, I am taking the actual values. On the x-axis, I am taking the predicted values. So here negative means there is no disease. I'm assuming like that. Positive means he's suffering from the disease. So actually means really the person has no disease, but here negative means the model predicted as negative. So TN means the true negative. So actually he is no disease, model also say that no disease, like that. So actually he is the no disease, model also predicted as no disease. So that is true, means model says that it's a negative, true. So what is the TP? TP means true positive. So actually has the positive, actually has the disease, so model also predicted as a disease, means this is a true, means the model predicted as a positive is a true. So this is correctly classified. This is also true positive, true negative is correctly classified. But here FP and FN, these are falsely predicted, means the TP, FP, here if you say FP, 0 as negative. 0 as negative means that actually is the negative, but predicted as the 1, that is the type 1 error. Means actually has no disease, but model predicted as the disease, that is the falsely predicted. So this is also F2, FN is also type 2 error, it is falsely predicted. Really, he is suffering from the disease, but model predicted as no disease. So this is the error, means false negative is the type 2 error, false positive is the type 1 error. So confusion matrix for the binary classification. So binary classification is a task of classifying the elements in the given data set into two classes, 0 and 1. So among the two class labels, class 1 as the positive class and class 0 is a negative class. So I am assuming like that. So confusion matrix for the two class would be 2 by 2 matrix. So here on the y-axis, I am taking the actual values, means n means negative. So I am considering negative is a 0, positive is equal to 1. So on the y-axis and the x-axis, I am considering the predicted values, negative is equal to 0, predicted as 1. So means negative means true negative, and negative and positive is the true false positive, and actually is the positive, and model predicted as negative, that is the false negative. Actually he is the positive, and model also predicted as positive, that is the true positives. So the terminologies in the confusion matrix. So that target variable has the two classes. Those are the positive means 1, negative is 0. I'm assuming like that. So columns represent the predicted values of the target variable. Rows represent the actual values of the target variable. So what is the positive here? So nowadays, this is the term is very famous, positive. Positive means actual value is positive. Means the patient has the disease. Positive means person is having the disease. Negative means no disease. And true positive, false negative, true negative, false positive, these are the terminals in the confusion matrix. So first we have to understand the true positive. Means the predicted values matches with the target values. So actual values means real values. So means the actual value means is positive. Actually is the positive patient and model also predicted as the positive. That is nothing but the true positive. What is the true negative? This is also be matching with the actual values. So here actually person is negative and model predicted has also be negative. This is the true negative. False positive is a type 1 error. For FE and FN means these are the falsely predicted by the models. Means actually he is no disease, but model predicted as the disease means positive. That is the type 1 error. What is the type 2? Actually, the person is positive, he is suffering from the disease and model predicted as the negative. That is the negative, means that is the type 2 error. So if you see the binary classification example, so here this is the our infection to the person, this is the actual values, this is the our target values, and this is the predicted values. Suppose I am taking this example. So actually one is the positive, 0 is the negative. So 1 is the positive and 0 is the negative. So actually he is positive patients, but model predicted also be 1. So it is correct. Here also negative, model is predicted as negative. It is also correct. This is true. This is true positive. And this is the true negative. But here 1 and 0. 1 is 0 means actually he is the positive and predicted as the 0. It is nothing but the 1 to 0. This is nothing but the false negative. So now we have to identify how many 1 to 1 means that. So here total number of rows means 10 rows. 10 rows. So how many 1 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 0 to 0. So here 1 to 1 means 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So these are the 1 to 1 is 3. So 1 to 1, 3. And 0, 1 to 0, 1, 0 to 1, 2, 0 to 0, 4. If you sum it, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 4, 10. So these are the total 10 records, 10 rows of the binary class. If you see, out of the 10, so in this example, so I am considering 0 to 0, 4, 0 to 1, 2, 1 to 0, 1, 1 to 1 is 1 to 0, 1, this is 1, 1 to 1 is 3, 3. So means here, I am assuming that in this example, 1 is positive, 1 is positive. So means 1 is positive. And 0 is negative. This is my actual negative and this is my actual positive. But here model predicted the negative 0, model predicted the 1. So means how many 0, 0, here 0 and this 0 matches. How many 0s are 0s and 0? 4. So this is the 4. How many 0s to 1? 0s to 1, 2. This is the 2. How many 1s and 0? So actually he is the 1 and model predicted is 0, that is the 1. And 1 and 1, that is the 3, that is the true positive. So I am assuming like that. So means out of the 10 patients, how many negative patients, how many has the healthy person, means negative means he is the healthy person. Means total 6 people are there. Out of 10, 6 people are negatives. And out of 10, 6 are the negative, 4 are the positive patients. Among the 4, only 1 person is wrongly predicted. And out of 6, 2 persons are the wrongly predicted. So means 4 are correctly predicted. So that is nothing but the. So true negative false, true P, true positive is 3, FP is 2, and FN is equal to 1. So what is the accuracy? Out of all classes, how much predicted correctly? How much predicted correctly? Means it is the ratio of the correct predictions to the total number of samples. Means accuracy works well only if there are equal number of samples belongs to the each class. Means that, so 1000 rows, total 1000 rows of the data set. Among the 1000 rows, 500 rows are the positive, 500 rows are the negative, means equal number of the classes, but that is nothing but the same classes. At that time only accuracy works well. If accuracy will be considered when the data is balanced, data is balanced in nothing but the target variable classes will have the equal number of samples. Equal number of samples means 500 positive and 500 negative, like that. So about 50 to 50 percentage are the same sample, or 40 to 60, like that. So in the two classes, one class is about 50 to 50 and 40 to 60, like that. This is the balanced data set. For unbalanced data, so unbalanced data means, suppose number of zeros is 900, number of ones is 100, means this is the unbalanced. So at that moment, accuracy was not good measure to predict the model performance. So to measure the model performance, so accuracy is make a key role. So if it is balanced data, 60-40% like that is we have to consider the accuracy. If it is 0 to 1 or 90% and 10% kind of the classes, we have to consider the unbalanced data set. So this is the formula. What is the formula? Correctly classified items by the all classes items. So correctly classified items means true positives and true negatives are the correctly classified items by the all classifications. All means, so in this confusion matrix, this is the true negative, this is the true positive, this is the false positive, and this is the false negative. So accuracy means TP plus TN by all items, like that. So what is the error rate? So error rate is nothing but the 1 minus accuracy, like that. Means you can also write like that, incorrect predictions, FN plus FP by total items, TP, TN, FP, FN, like that. So what is the precision? Precision is another name is the positive predictive value, PPV. Means that, so in this is the confusion matrix. So in this confusion matrix, 0 1 0 1, so this is the true negative, this is the true positive, this is the false positive, this is the false negative. So means that it is implied as the measure the correctly identify the positive cases, correctly identify the positive cases from the all predicted positive cases. All predicted positive cases means this is the predicted values and this is the actual values. So in this predicted values, so this part means TP plus FP is nothing but the predicted positive classes. Predicted positive classes means TP plus FP. Out of TP plus FP, how much we correctly identified, means how much you correctly identified, nothing but the TP. So that is the formula of the precision. Precision means TP, this TP by TP plus FP. TP plus FP means this is the part indicating the predicted positive cases by the model. So precision is important. So in spam detection models, for example, we have to consider the given mail is spam mail or not spam mail. This is the scenario. So in this case, we have to consider the precision. Why? Because by classifying the genuine email, so that is the genuine email, can be considered the spam, and blocking it will be lead to the loss of some important information addressed to the people. Means that actually this is the genuine mail, but it is also be predicted as the spam mail. So at that moment of time, people used to register some important information. So this kind of examples, we have to consider the precision, which is also known as the positive predictive value. Next, recall. What is the recall? It is also named the sensitivity, also known as TPR. TPR is nothing but the true positive rate. True positive rate. So it is implied that to measure the correctly identified the positive cases means in this confusion matrix 0 1 0 1, true negative, true positive, false negative. So means that correctly identified positive cases. So this is the correctly identified positive cases from the all actual positive classes. Here this is the actual negative, this is the actual positive. So actual all positive means this is the part, that is nothing but the TP plus FN. So that is the notation. So out of all actual positive cases, means TP plus FN. From this, how model is correctly identified as positive cases, nothing but the TP. Means in recall is very important in healthcare kind of problems. Healthcare means suppose cancer prediction, liver disease prediction kind of problems. At that moment of time, we have to consider recall is very important. For example, if you see in this case, this is actually is the negative. Actually is the positive, and this is the negative positive. Actually, this is the false negative. So in this case, really is suffering from the disease, but model says that you don't have disease. So that is nothing but the false negative. Actually has the disease, really is suffering from the disease, but model predicts the negative. So means in this case, people lost the some life. So that is the nothing but the false recall, which is also known as the true positive rate, also sensitivity. So it means that in healthcare kind of problem statements, the recall is very, very important. So what is the accuracy and FN score? So FN score is the harmonic mean of the precision and recall and gives the better measure of the incorrectly classified cases than the accuracy metrics. Means FN score is nothing but the 2 into precision into recall by precision plus recall. So this is the formula of the FN score. If you see, accuracy is used when the true positives and true negatives are the more important, while FN score is also be used when the false positives and false negatives are the crucial. Means accuracy can be used when the class distribution is similar. Means equal number of classes. Means this is the balanced data set. So balanced data set accuracy measure we have to consider. For imbalanced data set, the FN score will be considered. So this is the very important point. So based on balanced data, based on the target variable. In the target variable, how many classes? So in target variable suppose 0 or 1, there are only two classes. Since 0s are 900 and number of 1s is 100, so this is the imbalance. In the imbalance, this is the imbalanced data set, at that moment we have to consider the F1 score. Suppose in binary class, 600 are the positive, means 0, and 400 are negative, means 1. So at that moment, this is the balance. We have to consider the accuracy. So for balanced data set, we have to consider the accuracy. For imbalanced data, we have to consider the F1 score. That is the main difference between the accuracy and F1 score. So if you see the one example, there are 90 people. So there are 90 people who are healthy, means they have no disease, and 10 people who have the disease. Totally people are 100. So among the 100 people, number of zeros, means the number of negative is 90, and the number of ones is positive is 10 people. So let's say our machine learning model perfectly classified the 90 people as healthy, but it also classified the unhealthy people as healthy. So unhealthy people means these are the positive people and be considered the negative. So that is nothing but the FN. This is nothing but the FN. FN. So what will happen in this scenario? So let us see the confusion matrix and find the accuracy score. So I will repeat the problem again. So out of 100 people, 90 people are the negative. Negative means no disease. No disease means these are the healthy people. And 10 people are the positive. Positive means they have the disease. So in this data set, our machine learning model classified these 10 people be considered as the healthy people. Actually, these are the positive people. They are suffering from the disease. This disease people is the positive people. It be considered as the negative people. Means this is considered the wrongly. Means that is the false negative. So what will happen in this scenario? So see, actually, total 100 people. Among the 100 people, true negatives 90. So there is no FE. There is no FE. So total negative people are 90. Total negative people are 90 means total number of people, healthy people. Healthy people are 90 people, and 10 people are the positive people. Positive people means that is the wrongly predicted as the negative. So means the true negative is 90, TP is 0, this is TP value is 0, there is no TP and there is no FP, and FP is 0 and false negative is 10. So in this case, if you see the accuracy, so accuracy means TP plus TN. Means 0 plus 90 plus this is 90%. So our accuracy is 90%. Means out of 100 people, 90 people are correct predictions. Means that our machine learning model is doing great job for identifying the diseases. Okay. But out of 100 patients, 90 patients is negative, means no disease. Means true negative is 0, FP is 0, and 10 patients are the positive, means having the disease. So means here TP is 0 and false negative is 0. It's wrongly identified. So means out of 90 means true negative 0, FP 0. Out of 90 negative patients means healthy patients, model correctly predicted means no disease. So means that 100% correctly predicted for the 90 people. So accuracy in this case 90%. So means this. So here accuracy is 90%, but this model is very poor. Why? Because actually accuracy is good, but the model is poor. Why? Because all the 10 people who are unhealthy, these are classified as the healthy. So by this example, what we are trying to say, the accuracy is not a good metric for the when the data set is imbalanced. So when the data set is imbalanced, so imbalanced means these are the, for example, zeros are the means negative people 90, ones is 10. So this is the unbalanced data. So for unbalanced data, so this is accuracy is not a good evaluation metric. So at that moment we have to go for the F1 score. So F1 score means this is the, we have to consider the precision and recoil like that. Thank you. If you like this video, please share it and subscribe my channel. If you have any doubts, make it comment. Thank you.